name is Ikoya. I'm the creator and founder of Silky Socks, and I'm here today to do a review on this Dominican Bounce Converti Cap half wig, by Outre. But before we get into that, there's a few things that I would like you to do. If this is your first time coming to my channel, I want to say welcome so much. Here we do wig reviews, we give you hair tips, we do hair tutorials, we do product reviews every Monday and Friday. So if that's your type of thing that you're into, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button, then hit the bell. Why not? It's free. That way you won't miss anything when we drop it. And if you're watching over on Facebook, we love you over on the FB too. Go ahead on both platforms, give this video a like and a share, and let's have a conversation down below. Do you guys have Dominican Bounce? How do you feel about her? Is this a style that you would rock? I know she's big and a lot of hair, so for some people this might be a little much, but let's have a conversation about it. Let me know. And here at Silky Socks, I love my Silky Chicks. That is what I call my subs. I love to do a shout out every single video. And so today's Silky Chick shout out is going to Zildre Ellis. Thank you so much, Zil, for watching my videos, you guys. Zildre is my cousin down in New Orleans. I love her so much. She is such a sweetie pie. She is such a good time. And I'm so grateful to have family that not only supports me in real life, but also in my business and here on YouTube. So I thank you so much, cuz. I hope you enjoyed this video as well. And so now let's get into why you clicked that thumbnail. Let's get into Dominican Bounce. So this is Dominican Bounce. She is a part of Outre's Converti Cap wigs. I do believe that Dominican Bounce does come in a full wig. I don't know if her name is exactly Dominican Bounce. It's Dominican something. And she was an old half wig, but they've added it to the Converti Cap series. So if you're not familiar with the Converti Cap series, they are made by Outre. They're extremely affordable half wigs that you can style in a lot of different ways. That's the selling point on them, that they're super versatile. And so far, this is my second time reviewing one of those units, and I totally agree with that. She is heat friendly, but I'm not sure why you'd want to put heat in here. She is serving big hair, she is serving curly, and she is serving the bounce like she should. So I don't recommend doing that, but hey, I mean, it's your wig, you can do what you want to do. She is definitely giving me Janet Jackson. Control. Control. Do you see it? Are you feeling it? You know I love a good Jerry curl if you watch me here. So she is definitely giving me that. I'm rocking her in 1B. She does come in a series of colors. As you can see, here's her stock card. I'm gonna open it up so you can see the different styles that you can do with her, that they have it in here. And then of course she comes in an array of colors. Most of the colors are natural, so that's really, really nice. It has a deluxe cap, which is nice. And what makes this a little bit different than other half wigs, besides that you can do it in different styles, it has a drawstring in the back of the cap that really helps it lay flat. And it also is saying that it's bacteria resistant, so that's a good thing. I know that I reviewed one other wig from this series, the Pina Colada, and I wore the heck out of that thing. I ended up having to just throw it out because it got really matty quickly, because, you know, these curlier wigs, they're at a lower price point. They're not made to last forever, but half wigs are becoming really popular again, as well as headband wigs, and you can do, you know, the headband look in different looks with this, so that's what makes it super versatile. So all in all, I think she's pretty good. So let's go ahead and get into the unboxing and the styling of this unit. And also, if you are looking for a way to make your wigs look more natural, because I know we all want to make our wigs look natural as possible, right? Really seamless. We want to keep them guessing, is that her hair or is that a wig? Then go ahead and check out the description box. We do have a free download giving you tips on how to make your wigs look more natural. So now without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the pros, cons, styling, and unboxing. All right, so here she is, Dominican Bounce. I'm trying to get it out of that light. The light is just like shining right on the packaging. All right, so here she is. And she is like a tight curl. Almost reminds me of like a Jerry style curl. Very pretty. She is pretty long, and the density is still like, it looks like it's a lot more hair on the stock card than what it really is. You can still see a little bit through the cap, so that's why I have my darker black cap on, because you can see a little bit of the hair through the cap. So let's get into this cap construction. So you have three combs. You have this one big comb in the middle, then you have the two combs on the side, one comb on the back, and then instead of adjustable straps, you have the drawstring, which is nice because, you know, you can wear this in a single ponytail if you would like to. So let's go ahead and throw her on. Oh, wow. Okay, Dominicana. All right. So I'm just going to insert the combs a little bit so that she'll slide in place. Oh, wow, you guys. Super curly. It is definitely more of a silkier texture to this one. It actually has a little bit of a shine to her. I don't know if that's coming through on the camera or not, but the cap size is pretty good, and I'm not really needing to adjust it, but I'm just going to tighten it just because, but I don't feel like I needed to. Like, it's coming down pretty good. So let's go ahead and get into a 360. So here is Dominicana Bounce in the front. This is her to the right. This is her to the left. And this is her in the back. All right, so we're going to style her up. Come back, I will give you my pros, cons, and final thoughts on Dominican Bounce. Okay, you guys, so I'm back from styling Dominican Bounce. Now, I did do a few different looks, as you've seen in the beginning of the video when I was editing. I'm also going to insert some pictures here so you can see the five different looks that I did. I do like the flip over method the best, so I decided to stay with this. Now, Dominican Bounce is really simple, you guys. This is a half wig, so it's not, you know, a lot of work as far as styling. I already had my baby hairs and my hair gelled back, put my cap on, so all I had to do was readjust it and throw it back on. Now, I also put some of my brunette dry shampoo in here because, as I said, I don't know if it's coming through on camera, but in person it does kind of have a shine to this hair that makes it look fake, especially on synthetic hair. It can make it look a little wiggy, so I did spray some of that in to help with that and take it down a little bit. So I noticed after styling it in the different styles that I did, that because it's a synthetic curly wig, if you don't know, doing a lot of manipulation on this wig is going to make this wig not only get bigger, but it's going to make it get ratty. These wigs are really affordable, so they're not of the highest quality. They are half wigs, and since it is a synthetic curly wig, just doing a lot of manipulating, a lot of styles, I wouldn't recommend it if you want it to last, because it's not going to last very long. And just doing those five styles, I did realize how the curls were getting like a little bit tangled and clumpy, so I did go in with some lot of body mousse just to rub it in and help the curls like stay revived and have that bounce and not get so tangly. Now, I did not do like any brushing or anything like that because of the fact that it's a synthetic curly wig. If you do want to do something to it, I would suggest getting a pick and picking it out. You could definitely make it bigger, but that would be the only thing I would do. So, pros and cons. Pros: Dominican Bounce is super affordable. If you like big curly hair, she is a winner. The fact that you can do styles with her is fun. And if you are a lazy wig wearer, or maybe you suffer from having edge loss or something like that, if you want big curly hair, she's easy. All you got to do is put your headband on, pull it, you know, to the front so it can cover up your edges, and you have a lot of versatility that you can do with this wig, especially for the price. Cons: because it is a synthetic curly wig, it's not going to last very long, and the more you manipulate it and the more you style it, the more issues you are going to have with it. So even though I do like her, I would just recommend, if you want big curly hair, just pick a style to do and do that one. You don't want to do a lot of manipulating with this one. This one is not going to last you as long as some of the other units that are available in the line. So that is my pros and cons. I definitely think she is cute. She is easy. I'm loving this flip over. Super cute. And of course, when I take this wig off, I'm not going to put it back into the plastic bag that it came out of. I'm going to put it in my luxurious silky sack. A silky sack is a silk line bag that I invented to not only store your wigs, but to add longevity to them. The silk lining allows the hair to just glide, cutting down on the shedding, tangling, matting that it would do if you left it in the plastic that it came out of or back into a box. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you will join me again on Monday. And remember that better care is better wear. Thank you.